Right. So we spiral down. There's going to be the lake that has the hole at the bottom. But we kind of cycle on down in order to get there. And there's.
There was that one trap. Yeah, that fell a bit. That's you actually because there was a boatload of TNT in there, and it's basically a waterfall you have to swim up, and there were vines and cobwebs, and the whole room was primed to explode.
I see.
So I felt that it was a bit little bit too mean. Because it was basically, if you open the chest, you're instantly almost dead if you don't block or don't have blast protection.
I see. And so there's a hole in the ceiling with some glass here that basically lets the moonlight shine through, I guess.
Yeah, and if you actually look up, you can actually not see the sky, which I also think is pretty nifty
Is that
about
just because of
glass.
the multiple layers of glass, effectively?
Yes.
I see. I'm noticing when I'm swapping between the Orbolt to torch and not, when I try to turn it off, it takes like 15 seconds or something before night vision actually goes away.
Yeah, somebody, I don't remember who that said to me like, yeah, service can be sometimes a bit laggy, or just single player, this game in general. So if I did it at 1 or 2 seconds, and you had a little bit of lag, then the night vision would go away for a bit, if you had a
Right.
lot of lag. So that
Right.
was why I put it on 15
Yeah, I think
seconds.
15 is too high. I think something like 5 would be better because I'm finding it.
Okay.
Yeah, not very useful, and it would have really annoyed me if I'd actually found it in the map, I think. All right, so there was this little side room, and then you could continue over here. And this room, I think, also has something down in the bottom. I think it's just
Yeah,
like a
the
standard creeper trap or whatever, and then an emerald was down here, maybe?
yes.
Yeah. Very nice. And.
Oh yeah, now I added these stairs to the bottom because they were previously not. And yeah, some people just filled this with sand and just did it that way.
I see. And so the
And I
stairs or slabs basically prevent you from dropping gravity blocks down there.
yeah, so one more step to it.
Right.
There's still an easy way around it, but yeah. Figure that one out for yourself.
So, looking in this chest, this is kind of like an early chest, and it seems like, in general, from what I remember, the loot in this area was rather underwhelming.
Yeah.
And so was this originally like supposed to be an earlier area, or I mean, I know it's not one of the tone walls, but like what is there a story?
It's just an easy area overall, and this was more meant to be quantity loot, just some more supplies.
Got it.
And this area just in general is has this like really awkward terrain. Like this is not that hilly, but in the main chamber, it actually gets
Right. It's
way
definitely
more
true that the
hilly.
terrain is, yeah.
And I this was more to be of like condition, bring your own stuff, and slowly get in that situation where you have no supplies.
Okay, as I'm walking in here, there's immediately a Grand Treasure Chest here. I don't remember this being here.
Yeah, that was actually originally up there. That was the
I see.
axe.
It was up top.
Yeah.
Got it. Was there a reason to move it, or?
Yeah, that whole section, because this area is also quite big. So I felt like that section
I see. Okay, let me
was
go.
really secluded.
Yeah, let me go fly out into the main area and see if I can see which section. Okay, so there are the kind of like circle of things that lead over to the lava levitation area. Over here is the thing that leads over to the black wool area. Under here is where there's the teleporter
That
to
was, yeah.
back to whatever. There's this pedestal that's right here.
Yeah, you never figured it out, did you?
Oh,
Did
there's
you?
something to figure out?
Did you actually read the comments? Because somebody guessed it
Oh, there
right.
was a different pedestal. I thought they were talking about putting torches on the pedestal up in the castle. I now that you said it, I just immediately noticed that there's torches on two end, but not torches on the other two.
Yeah, this is basically me being a Legend of Zelda fanboy.
Right. Okay, go ahead and place the torches. Let's watch what happens.
Dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. And then it would summon a chest.
Oh, wow. Oh, that's a nice chest.
Yeah, if you figured it out.
All right. Just because we're talking about that, if we go up to the castle that has the wool at the end of this area.
So the loot is not totally mean.
Indeed. Basically, up here where you get the fake diamond armor. For some reason, when people had the comment about the torches or whatever, I thought they were saying, because I remember, I guess it was the redstone torches that were on the pillars over here. I just remember there being torches on pillars, and I read the comment on the video, and I thought they were talking about this area. And I was like, oh, there must have been a
Oh,
missing torch
yeah.
somewhere. And so I thought people were talking about that. I didn't realize it was the pedestal back over at the
Oh,
beginning. So I saw your comments, people, but it didn't register link up with the correct area. All right, that makes more sense.
yeah.
I guess before we go to the wool castle there, I just want to get an overview of this area. Of course, I burned this all down, and you had the perfect kind of like payback surprise for people who burned it down.
Yeah, at first this was really extreme. Like when you burn it down, there would be always like 6 to 10 ghasts flying around, just constantly barraging you. I felt that was a little bit too much, so I toned it down. But I think I toned it down a bit too much as well.
I see.
I have to wait to see
Yeah,
some
I
other
think it
guys
might
play
be.
it.
Well, yeah, I don't know. It
Oh, wait,
depends.
maybe I
We're in
should.
one of the later areas, so that it's the case that, yeah, good luck with that. Maybe in creative mode you can do it. You can always
Maybe I.
fill replace fire with air.
Yeah, but I should
I am
remove
seeing my
frame
frame
rate.
rate, yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
But yeah, these were also one of the few places where you had kind of a type of mixer spawner. There's just skeleton spawner here, but a little bit deeper on, there's sometimes gas and sometimes blaze.
Yeah,
Is it just
so
50-50 or?
it's 75% ghast. And 70, 25% blaze.
I see.
So the spawner is also completely encased in bark, so that you actually could not
Oh.
see the sparkly flames.
I see. Unless you're burning the place down, right?
Yeah, unless.
Although, yeah, once those mobs spawn, then they'll start burning the place down. I guess for the most part, they're kind of deep enough in the tree that it's very hard for the mobs to spawn unless you've burned it down, so there's some airspace.
Yeah, and my second anti-burning magic is these other small spawner
Right.
thingamajigs with 2K spiders and 2 skeleton spawners, and they are all placed in such a way that in a 4x4 around them, they have no way to spawn, but they are really close to the surface. So if this actually does burn away, they will immediately spawn and start to harass you.
Can we put it on can you go ahead and fill that back in, and can we put it on non-peaceful? I feel like they do spawn. We'll see if I'm a liar or not. I probably am. I'm just worried that like the soul sand is like not a full block or something, and so it's somehow allowing them to spawn. I guess maybe not.
It should now spawn. Yeah.
Yeah, all right. I guess you're right. I felt like I saw them even before I burned it down, but I think I'm a liar because I think you're right in terms of just looking at the.
That's probably because of a creeper explosion.
It could be. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So if it blew out a hole over here, then all of a sudden there's a spawning space, for example. Yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, and so once it was the case that I found a couple of those, I just kind of like started, taking them all out. Because yeah, my usual strategy is you know, I want to conquer the map and get the objectives, but I also just want to pacify all the areas and light everything up. And so it's like, okay, here's more work for me to do.
And also do it in a methodical fashion, like seeing the words repeating sequence.
Seeing the repeating sequence.
A map maker does something over and over, like
Oh yeah,
hiding a spawn
pattern.
and city. Yeah,
Yeah.
pattern. Oh, jeez.
Let's see. I think
Take
the
off the f
I maybe have lost you. Okay, yeah. I think maybe
Yeah.
this is the first of these spider areas that I found because I wasn't investigating the water all that much yet, and I think this is maybe the only one that didn't have kind of an entrance in the water. And I think the first time, right, of course I was using the axe because the first time I came over here I didn't have a sword in my inventory.
Oh yeah, and then you made a stone sword.
Yeah. And I don't remember if I ever ended up making efficiency shears. Efficiency shears are a really nice way that
I think you actually did.
oh, I did? Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
They're a good way to cut through cobwebs.
The web slayer, that's the iron swords.
Right, I'd
Oh
already
yeah,
repaired that 3 times, I think, at this point.
I actually have one in my inventory,
I
yeah.
see.
It actually
Yeah, the web slayer was very good. I was trying not to kind of like abuse it once I got out of abandoned mines, just in case I was gonna need it again, but yeah, I think I kind of used it up. And Thunder Jabber. Okay, so once again, if I'd realized that this had plus attack speed, it would have been a little bit more interesting loot to me.
Oh yeah, let's write that down.
Oh yeah, you're making notes for one more update on the map.
So these small caves all got their piece of special loot in combination with just some supplies again. And I think they're okay for this late in the map. If you die a lot, this map is actually, or this
Right.
map,
Yeah, it's
this
the
loot is
usual kind of thing.
actually
Every
quite
CTM
good.
I feel like faces, you know, towards the end, you have two classes of people. You have the class of people who didn't die very often and have built up good gear, and you have the class of people who die a lot and are still working with, you know, whatever gear they found in the most recent chest.
Yeah,
And at the end of the map, it's very hard to balance for those two cases.
that's why some maps give out these like really big veins of iron ore, for instance. So you
Right.
actually so you at least have the minimal level of iron to fall back on.
Right.
This map doesn't really have that. Yeah, it has the iron in Miner's Dream, but that's really it.
Right. I'm just in spectator mode flying below so that I can kind of see all the spider areas. I was kind of surprised that there wasn't an emerald hidden down inside one of them, just because it seemed like the type of place that an emerald might be hidden.
Yeah, I didn't really think about that.
But I mean, it's fine. Oh, here's the command box for the chest, I presume. That teleports up. Okay, neat. Let's see. Okay, so there were the different spider areas down there. And then so I don't immediately see what is kind of different in shape or size about the area than what I've. Oh, that's right. There was a whole section. Okay.
Yeah, the whole
The
section at the
waterfall
beginning.
up. There used to be a waterfall like coming down from the ceiling over here or something.
You
Right here.
originally had to make it yourself.
Right. I didn't realize it because I did that first. Okay. So this is from. Right. This is the little dig shortcut. Okay. Got it. Okay. So that's that waterfall. But then I guess somewhere else over here. Oh, right, there was like the island in the middle. Oh, it's still here. Okay.
Yeah, that's still here.
I forget what this had in it. It was another treasure box with
Yeah, I was a
Den Razor, sharpness one, diamond sword.
Yeah, it's that's all right. This at first, the water shortcut down at the back of the island was actually closed like this, which I also changed to this in an update I have to release. Which is me being a bit of a derp. Yeah, you have so many things to think about when mapping that you forget. sometimes forget these simple things.
Right. Yeah, I mean, with even vanilla Swirl or whatever, where it's kind of easier to update, maybe from the point of view that it's programmatically done. Like, I still have, like a huge to-do list
Yeah,
that I just keep in a document.
I know how it is. When beta testing this map, like the first beta test, I have like 300 things that I need to fix. It's so bad.
All right. Yeah, I remember kind of like it was hard for me to kind of get a mental idea of how this whole area was laid out, but part of that was by virtue of the
Yeah.
fact that I was burning the trees down, and so it looked one way, and then I came back and it looked a different way.
That is actually also part of the design of Zero. This whole area is pretty dark, and there are always trees in your way and all these hills. So there are no open parts to say like, "Oh yeah, I remember this area." It's all just a bit mazy like.
Got
All
it.
looks samey but different.
Right. And then the
That's
first time I got to about right over here, and I heard an explosion. And it was from the miner's dream next door, but I didn't know that at the time.
We're not going to hear those blow up because of difficulty being on normal.
I see. Yeah, I've got difficulty on peaceful. So yeah, with my night vision, it's very easy to see that there's something there. I don't remember if I had the night vision or not when I actually found it. I might have actually just seen it because I was swimming up the waterfall. So yeah, behind the waterfall, you only did that. You did that in Drizzled Cove as well. And it used to be the case that it was behind the lava fall in the cliffs, but I guess you moved that one.
And Big Leaf Forest, I did it a lot as well.
I see.
Because it's like, yeah, a waterfall, of course, something has to be behind it. Same for the shortcut tunnel, actually.
Right. Which someone said they never found.
Oh.
There was,
Yeah, it was lit up as well,
yeah, there
so
was
I
a group
wanted
of
to make
people in my
sure.
comments that said that they played through the whole map and found all the emeralds and didn't find that shortcut. And I was
Oh.
kind of blown away by that.
Ouch. Yeah.
So yeah,
And then.
standard supply chest.
And then here's the transition.
Right, over to the miner's dream. Okay, we don't need to go over here yet because we still have the castle over here. And I guess since we're over here relatively near the Red Wool area, should we go over there next?
Yeah. Let's do that.
Okay, just in spectator mode, come down to this little hallway that was at the end. That leads to. So, this was another kind of like weird thing about this area. Is it didn't have any emeralds listed, and the area name,
It's so big. This was also one of those experimental areas.
right. When you fall up, you got to pick yourself down. And is that like, does it sound like some music lyrics or something, or,
I don't know. It's just a play on words that I did.
okay, I didn't catch the reference if there was one.
No, I didn't have any reference in mind. There's probably something named like that. But yeah. No reference
Okay.
intended.
And yeah, you relatively kind of clearly spelled out kind of what to expect out of this area. Levitation, fire, don't bring fire resist. So I kind of
No
thought it was going to
buckets,
be about what
no
it turned out to
bows.
be.
I think overall this area turned out to be too much trial and error at some parts. My intention with this was. Where are you?
I'm
You're
starting
over
to just, I
here.
just, at the very
Oh,
beginning, I
yeah.
just started flying up now.
Yeah. So my intention was like, oh yeah, you can see there's nothing at the end of this tunnel, so choose a different one. And I did that exactly at the beginning. So you come through the first hole, so you know, like, oh yeah, I have to go through these holes. And you can see nothing in the first one. So I was basically telling you, like, hey, you need to try to move and to look out.
Got it.
I think that sometimes doesn't click with most players. This area could be one of the deadliest ones.
I see. Yeah, I could definitely see people taking a lot of deaths if they didn't save up gear that would help them do this, and they don't decide to cheat with the fire resist potion. That's another thing that I like is you just said don't use a fire resist potion, And so, yeah, if people otherwise are getting stuck, they could always just use a fire resist potion if they just
There,
got tired of it.
fire resist is actually
Oh, command
getting
box canceled out or something?
yeah, it's getting it's it is getting swept away from
I
you.
see.
Getting
Oh,
beat.
interesting.
At least it should be. Yeah.
I see. And then someone pointed out to me, I didn't realize this mechanic, that basically levitation causes you to rise unless you're inside a liquid, in which case you have to hit
Yeah.
the space bar in order to swim up it. I did not realize
Yeah.
that, and so there were points where I was kind of like stuck going back downwards until I, moved off to the side to get out of the lava.
Yeah, this part is probably one of the meanest parts because you have to figure out which one it is. There are three ones, I believe. This one, yeah, this one. It's probably one over here, and then somewhere, and this one. And you went through this one, I believe.
Wow, so I got lucky.
Yeah,
Yeah, I was
and
gonna,
you.
I had enough if I, especially if I had figured out that I could swim up through the lava, like I had enough fire protection on my armor and golden apples and different things that I probably could have just swum up through the wrong one if I needed to.
So shulkers, this is the only place I use them in the map.
Right?
They should normally teleport away to somewhere because they are not on any blocks.
I see.
They always need to be on blocks, but there are no blocks in a certain range of them.
I see, so they
And
can't teleport. Got it.
I don't know what it is, but when I was playtesting as well, I constantly kept it on normal, but they would actually despawn, which I have no idea why.
You could just
So,
add a persistent tag to them, right?
yeah, but they still kept disappearing.
Huh.
But how I actually did it is with the
Are they riding an armor stand or something?
no, with the when you begin this area, let me see. Yeah, over here with the at the tunnel. Starter tunnel
Let me fly out and find it.
to the north of the whole lava curtain.
Got it.
Yeah, in the starter room with the golden pressure plate, it actually triggers a mechanism which first off, kills all the shulkers just in case they were actually not despawning for you, and then spawns them
I see. Got it.
just to make sure. And yeah, and that does it only one time. So you would actually not get. Not when you try to actually kill them every time, because I saw somebody actually try to kill them every time they got here, like take an axe with them, and every time they actually
I see.
come to this part, they will kill them.
I can't remember. I knew that you could bounce back their projectiles just by, like punching them, kind of like a gas fireball or whatever. And I think maybe you can also block them with a shield.
This area, this part of the area can actually be quite difficult, but the way to actually survive this area, because these are moving projectiles,
Right.
you actually, if you're standing still, the shulker ball will actually end up being under you and then will go up
Right.
to hit you into the lava. So the trick to this area is just to keep moving.
I see. And yeah,
Wait.
you kind of needed to keep moving anyway because you're like trying to dodge all of the little bits of lava that are kind of hidden around everywhere.
This area also used to be way harder. Ooh, one heart. But yeah, this area used to be ridiculously hard, and I made it.
I see. Well,
Something that I could do every time, like almost every time. But yeah, of course, not everybody could do that when they first do this area.
right.
And as you also saw there, like when you jump down, you actually get the levitation again.
Right.
And right about here, it starts to get removed, and then you can close the trapdoor under you, and then you can fall down on it.
I was very glad to have a button that said push to escape this horrible place.
Yeah, because how else could you really?
Right.
As something else that you probably didn't think about, I already removed iron bars.
Oh,
Because
yeah. Oh, because you didn't
I
bring a
didn't.
pick.
Yeah.
Right. Yep.
And there used to be a bug where I, with the levitation, let me get some. That when you go up and you press shift, I'm now not pressing shift anymore. And I think, oh, yeah, oh. Oh, yeah. Previously, when you press shift like this, you would go still up because your model would go a bit down. And then when you let go, you would suffocate into the
I see.
ceiling and you would actually go through it.
Mojang.
Yeah. They actually fixed it, so
Yeah,
which
that's good.
is. Hey, what is this? Oh. Okay.
And then, right, there was a whole lot of loot here. And so I was glad I had enough room to kind of like fill my pockets because I didn't bring very much.
Basically me saying a bit of a sorry for like killing
Yeah,
you so many times with that, because I heard from somebody that he died like 50 times in this area.
I
So
see.
getting this loot at the end is nice. Ooh, two mending books.
Yeah.
That is an infinity. Yeah, this is one of the most generous books chests.
Yeah, I think I did this area near the end because I needed to be like in the right mood and frame of mind, just like based on, what the sign said and what I was kind of expecting it to be. And I was worried that I was gonna die, but yeah, I was trying to keep my death down. I think I only died 10 times in this map. I was trying to keep my death down as much as possible. And
And you did a good job.
yeah, and so I decided, all right, I'm gonna do first try. I'm gonna bring kind of like all my best stuff to try to survive. It worked, hooray.
What?
Indeed. But yeah, I was glad as a result of using that strategy that it also meant that that area was short. All right, should we check out the castle with the bull?
Yes. So this castle was actually kind of influenced by Skyrim's barrows. Like what was that final one called? I think Skuldavn. And the way that was built, it was basically this layered blocks on top of each other, and then of course they are decorated, of course, so they wouldn't just look like blocks. And it had this layer system where with like a pyramid,
Right.
like every next layer is a bit smaller, and then it had all these pillars and arches everywhere.
I
That was
see.
basically what I wanted to go for.
And then it has this, yeah, degraded down look as though, did you actually like make the castle and then explode a few pieces of TNT in order to create it, or is it simulated, or?
That is precisely what it is.
Okay. Because it did look a whole lot like it had been, yeah, assaulted by some TNT. And yeah, you had to give me a hint in order to find this one emerald that was down here. I think if I hadn't been towards the end of the map, like the last few episodes, like I recorded over like the course of like a month or something, because I went out of town a couple of times.
Yeah, I know.
And with long breaks in the map, it's yeah, it's harder to get kind of like back into it and motivated. And so I think if I had been a little bit more motivated, I probably would have found that one on my own, but I appreciated the hint.
Yeah. So somebody fought like a chest at the end with hints of all the emeralds, or
Right.
yeah, that would be a bit like anticlimactic, like the final episode should be the rule. But maybe at the end of the rule boxes, or maybe at every emerald chest, you would get a hint to the next emerald.
You could do something like that. It would be, yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. It would be,
It's
I think it
something
almost
that
might even be better just to like have a forum thread where you could have like spoilers for 1 through 54,
Oh
and
yeah.
that
Yeah, okay,
way
I
if
think.
you need a hint on number 7, you can just look at a hint on number 7 kind of thing.
Yeah, okay, that would be better. Or just a book maybe a book at the beginning of the map, just having it.
I guess if you can set up the book easily so that it has like the page jump so that you can look at the hint for number 7 without accidentally seeing the hint for number 6 kind of thing.
Oh, yeah. So. Yeah, okay. Then it's better to have a forum thread.
Yeah, you could probably do some things in game, but I almost feel like that's one that's fine to have out of game. Because I imagine, yeah, only a few people will need it or want it or whatever. And then there was an emerald somewhere in here as well. I don't remember exactly. Like, it's near the wool, I think.
Yeah, on top of the room.
And were there monsters up here? I don't remember if I came up here because I heard monsters or...
Yeah, natural mobs could spawn here. There shouldn't be any spawners. No.
Okay. I see. And there's the emerald. Yep.
Yeah, with a little lighting cue. Oh yeah, the troll diamond armor.
Right. It took me a while.
Yeah, I was a bit hesitant on using this, as you have not really any way to actually see.
The fact that it has the like win on body colon and then it's a blank. Is, you know, for the people who do read, you know, the bottom bits to try to understand.
But the enchantment part, I was a bit hesitant on, was like, if you have no armor and just get protection 4 on all, that would be actually pretty good. And in fact, this is only 4 and 3. The other stuff is lower. And I, of course, made the repair costs really high.
Right. Yeah, we thought of that. Yep. Yeah, that was the first thing I did. And then I realized that, it wasn't actually giving me the protection.
Also, a little way of knowing that this isn't real is because this isn't a grand treasure chest.
Oh, like something like this. That's true. This would definitely be in a grand treasure chest. Right? And I forget, I think there's like skeleton spawners in the corners over here. Maybe Endermen as well. Yeah, there's an Enderman and a skeleton, I think.
Yeah, there are Enderman spawners late in the map, and there are skeleton spawners over.
They're kind of like, and all the places kind of coming towards it. I see, and up here, okay. It's amazing, how many of these details of the map, like, you end up remembering after you've played it.
Mm-hmm.
Because, I watch people play maps and then, like, see them go back and they remember all these fine details. And I was like, I don't remember that from watching you. But when you actually play it, it's a different experience.
Yeah. Because you're more focused on the commentary, I feel like, with not playing it yourself.
Interesting. Yeah, I hadn't thought about it in terms of my LP style is very kind of explanatory.
You're right. Most LPers aren't that explanatory and well able to word their thoughts and plans.